فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
قالت امرأة العزيز. Are we all together? Here we have قالت. This is a kasra right now. It should have been a sukun. The reason why is because remember the alif al-wasl, it drops when you're in the middle of a context. So then what's going to happen? The sukun on that lam and the sukun on this one are going to both hit each other. And then what's going to happen from that is called iltiqa'u sakirini, the meetings of the two sukuns. Are we all together? Iltiqa'u, the meetings of the two sukuns. So what we need to do is to avoid that. And how do we avoid it? We just say that this has to become a kasra. It has to become a kasra. I hope that makes sense. So now, قالت امرأت العزيزي. You don't say قالت امرأت العزيزي. Can't say that because التقاء ساكنين. Okay. The second sign it shows is what's known as تاء الفاعل. تاء الفاعل is basically when the word has the pronoun, it's got the ضمير الرفع المتحرك connected to it. Let's explain that, inshallah, what that means. The word was what? The word was what? Qala. Sah? You want to say, I said. How do you say that? You say, Qultu. Qultu. Qul. Qulta. Qul. All of those are what? They're called ta'ul fa'il. Why are they called ta'ul fa'il? Because they are the subject. Qultu, I said. Who's the one who said this? Who's the one who's saying? Huh? Me. So that by itself is me. I'm the fa'il. Qulta, you said. The ta here is the fa'il. Qulti, you said, sister. You're the fa'il. So the ta is a fa'il by itself. Are you with me? Does that make sense? And the difference between that one and the one I mentioned before, are you with me? Is that when the ta al-damir al-raf' al-mutaharrik, the damir raf' al-mutaharrik, this ta, when it connects to the word, two things is a distinct characteristic for you to recognize. The first one is that the ta'u ta'nith is sakina, it doesn't change the word. It leaves the word the way it is and it just adds on to it. Like the word originally was qala, it just adds on to it like that. Does that make sense? That's one. Number two, qultu, it doesn't. Qultu, look at the word was qala, it took out the alif and it stuck these two together. That's number one. It changes the binya and the construction of the madhi. The second thing is that this has got a sukoon on it. Generally speaking, unless the iltiqa'u sakinain. Whereas this one is damir raf' mutaharrik. Mutaharrik here means what? It's got haraka on it. Haraka are only three things. The opposite of sukun, which is dhamma, fatha, or kathra. One of those are going to be on the ta. Okay, it's not going to be a sukun. And either one of them, whatever it may be, okay, whatever it may be, pay attention to this, wherever it may be, they both indicate that this is madhi, okay? This is a bit too much details. We will study that in more details, inshallah ta'ala, as we go on. All you need to now know is there's two signs that can enter the madhi that are unique for it. And the first one is ta'u ta'nithi sakina. And I added on it for you the ta' al-fa'il. The ta' which is the fa'il. The author didn't do that. Very good. We have two other, we've got the third verb that we're going to go to. The third verb, the third type of verb is what? Fi'l amar. Fi'l amr is basically a command. It's a command verb. When basically somebody is commanded to do something. Stand up. Sit down. This is called a what? Fi'l amr. Now, Ajrumiyyah, he didn't speak about fi'l amr. He didn't even mention a science for it. He didn't. لم يتطرق إليه. He didn't even go that direction. But what we did is that, since we're talking about af'al, we've done what is known as takmila. We completed it off and tatimma. So we said that the fi'l amr is two things have to be in it. The first one is دلالته على الطلب. For us to say that this is a فعل أمر, it has to indicate a request, that something is being requested here. So when somebody says to you, قم, stand up. Okay, the first condition that it's a فعل أمر is that قم is stand up. Okay, قم is what? It's what? It's stand up. Good, mashallah. Does قم show a request that you're being requested to do something? Does it? Like when I tell you stand up, am I requesting you to do something? By telling you to stand up, yes I am. So قم is a فعل أمر. Number one, the first condition is present. The second condition that's meant to be in it is that وَقَبُولِهِ, and it has to accept يَا الْمُؤَنَّثَةِ الْمُخَاطَبَةِ. In other words, I can use that same word to speak to a female. So I could say if I wanted to, قومي. Are you with me? Can I say قومي? Can I say قومي? Would that be right or wrong? Yeah? Yes, I can. I can say that. Are you with me? So it does accept the ya al mu'annathat al mukhataba. This ya is basically when you're talking to a woman. When you say to a man, قم, it's a man you're telling. When you're speaking to a woman, what do you say? You say قومي, stand up. It's funny because I study linguistics in university, and one of the modules that we were studying is basically called gender and sexuality. And we were speaking about, is it correct to use terms to distinguish between male and female, or is it right for everybody to be spoken the same way? That should we have this principle called مذكر and مؤنث, masculine and feminine words? Or should everybody just have equality even in the way we address men and women? And I was actually shocked, man. A lot of the students in the class were for the idea that it's injustice, that male and female, that, you know, there is separate terms, that the woman is a she and the man is a he. You guys know there's toilets now in public places which is unisex toilets. Men and women can go in. Don't know that? Yeah, London. Am I the first person to hear that? I have seen one though. There has been one toilet that I saw that was unisex. Male and female go into the toilet together. Everybody does their business. Because it's quality and, you know. And now it's funny now. Now pay attention to that. This is language, because language is important and how people are addressed and people are spoken to. See, we're mudakkar, mu'annath. We're saying qum is a man, qumi is a woman. It's different. Distinguish between the people. They're saying that, no, this is injustice. This is dhulman, udwan, oppression. And you know, it's coming to that. Those people that you, 10 years ago, that you thought they were radical in their thoughts, and you thought it's impossible that these people will be heard, and it's possible that their rights and their movement is going to be given any consideration, and any law will be passed regarding it. Now they've got the upper hand. You say anything about them, you're finished. Huh? Janaz is going to be prayed on you. Every little discussion that you have, they bring up this minority and this minority group and say, what do you believe about them? Sah? It's a reality. So here, pay attention. So what I'm trying to get to a point. So one of the funniest things I came across was that they said that a person's gender can be male or female. Okay, no problem. Like, Allah can create you as a male and Allah can create you as a female. But does that mean your sexuality is the same? And you can have whatever sexuality, you can choose that if that's your choice. So we have to distinguish between gender and sexuality. Okay, now that we do distinguish between it, when we're addressing a person who's chosen their sexuality to be opposite to their gender, which language should we use for them? Should we use their gender, or should we use the sexuality which they've chosen? Sir? Are you with me? This is the khilaf that's happening in the universities, right? So you're sitting there thinking to yourself, what am I doing in this class? But it's a niqash, ilmi. This is academic. This is secular knowledge. Come on, brother. Be wise. Be part of the program. See what's happening here. And that's a problem. Wallahi, that's the reality. That's what's happening in campuses. And so I was told, okay, what's your point of view? I was like, yeah, اختلف العلماء. They differed. So what can I do? I mean, who shall I be with? صح? And it's scary because things that you're thinking to yourself, like, wallahi, maths today, kufriyat have been taught in it. The most simple. What's linguistics got to do with any? Huh? It's language, man. Just teach me linguistics and stick to that. How on earth did a module get dragged into that in the class and it gets discussed? And to be honest, I think it's the most like old-fashioned class because the class I go to, there are old aunties, very old pensioners who want to study these modules on the side. ذلك, there's fitan wa fasad wa arid. Allah bi alim. Only Allah knows. So it's a problem. In our religion, there is difference. Not only difference in wordings, but the difference in segregation. Okay? And this is something I remembered when I was studying linguistics. The Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah said, language has an effect on a community and a people. Are you with me? Colonies, when they went to countries, what did they try to do? Language. Oh yes. Language and culture, if you can tap into people's culture, you can have influence in people's cultures, like the food that they eat, you take it on board. They take on board your language. There's a door for you to take on what they're upon. That's it, wallah. You start walking like them, you start acting like them. Language actually affects a person's behavior, it does. So they realize that, so they're going for the fundamental things. So they go into language. So if these terms get left, like right now, if you look at 90% of what's been spoken about atheism, if you keep looking at it, is the definition of what is a fact? What's a theory? What's a hypothesis? Huh? Are you with me? What's empty? What's nothing? What's something? I swear, wallahi, the definition of nothing is one of the biggest discussions they're having. How did something come out of nothing? But what is nothing? And what is something? صح? What is a fact? What's a theory? What's a hypothesis? Is science a fact or a theory? صح? But what is fact? So what I mean is that this is where the tadakhul of the fitan, and this is, ulama have already mentioned it. Sahih? Scholars have already mentioned it. So it's very important to strengthen your language. Whatever language that you're studying, whether it be English, whether it be French, whether it be Chinese, Japanese, it doesn't matter, Arabic. If you don't have a strong base in the language, definitions can cause you a lot of headache. صح? And that people who deviated from the path of Ahl Sunnah, they did because of language, the definition of words. صح? At-ta'arif. So it's important that we understand that. Coming back to the point, qum is for a man, stand up. And qumi is what? Qumi is what? Qumi is a feminine way of saying it. So does the word qum accept? Does it show the meaning of request? Yeah, it does. Does it also accept ya al-mu'annathat al-mukhataba? Yes, it does. So then we can now say that qum is a fi'l amr. Okay? Are you with me? Very good. We're now going to move on to the last. So we finished the. We've finished. We finished the signs of the Amr. We're now going to go to the last sign, which is. Now let's just quickly go over what Sheikh Muhammad Muhyiddin Abdul Hamid said in his Tuhfat al-Saniya. He says, وَأَقُولُ يَتَيَمَّيَّزُ الْفِعْلُ عَنْ أَخَوَيْهِ الْإِسْمُ وَالْحَرْفِ بِأَرْبَعِ عَلَامَاتٍ مَتَى وَجَدْتَ فِيهِ وَاحِدَةً مِنْهَا أَوْ رَأَيْتَ أَنَّهُ يَقْبَلُهَا عَرَفْتَ أَنَّهُ فِعْلٌ الأولى قد والثاني سين والثالث صوف والرابعة تاء التأنيث الساكنة أما قد فتدخل على نوعين من الفعل. As for قد, he said it enters two types of verbs وهما الماضي والمضارع. There they are. ماضي المضارع فإذا دخلت على الفعل الماضي دلت على أحد المعنيين. And if it enters onto the ماضي, it shows one of two meanings. So when it enters the ماضي, one of two meanings is what you take from it. وهما, and they both are, التحقيق والتقريب. The first one is التحقيق and the second one is التقريب. فمثال دلالتها على التحقيق قوله تعالى. The example, even when it shows Tahqiq is the statement of Allah, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. That's the first one. وَقَوْلُ جَلَّ شَأْنُهُ, and also the statement of Allah, لَقَدْ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. That's the second one. Second one for the first example, which is a tahqiq. وَقَوْلِنَا, and also the statement that we say, قَدْ حَضَرَ مُحَمَّدٌ, Muhammad has verily come. وَقَوْلِنَا, and also our statement, قَدْ سَافَرَ خَالِدٌ, verily Khalid has traveled. All of those are tahqiq. وَمِثَالُ دَلَالَتِهَا عَلَى التَّقْرِيبِ قَوْلُ مُقِيمِ الصَّلَاةِ. The example of it showing taqrib, which is the second meaning, is when the person who's doing the iqama says, قَدْ قَامَتِ الصَّلَاةِ. Or when a person says, قَدْ غَرَبَتِ الشَّمْسُ, the sun has set. So here it means a qaruba waqta ghurub shamsi, the time when the sun will set is close. We finished the madi, we're now going to move on to the mudari'. Wa idha dakhalat 'ala al-fi'l al-mudari', when it enters the fi'l mudari', meaning qad, dallat 'ala ahad ma'nayayn, it shows one of two meanings aydan also, wa huma, and they are at-taqlil wa at-takthir. Fa amma dalalatu 'ala at-taqlil, so it shows either at-taqlil, which we wrote on the board, and at-takthir. When it shows a taqleel, فَنَحْوُ قَوْلِكَ, it's like when you say, قَدْ يَصْدُقُ الْكَذُوبُ, the liar may tell the truth. وَقَوْلِكَ, and your statement, قَدْ يَجُودُ الْبَخِيلُ, the stingy one may sometimes be generous. But that is little, is he? وَقَوْلِكَ, and your statement, قَدْ يَنْجَحُ الْبَلِيدُ, the dim-witted one may pass and pass the exam. وَأَمَّا دَلَالَتُ عَلَى التَّكْثِيرِ, and when it shows takthir, which is a lot, فنحو قولك, it's like your statement which you say, قد ينال المجتهد بغيته, the one who is striving may reach his goal and what he's looking for. وقولك, and your statement, قد يفعل التقي الخير, the taqi, which is the righteous pious one, he may do good. I mean, this is a lot, does he do good? Okay. وقول الشاعر, and the statement of the poet, قد يدرك المتأني, the mut'anni is the one who's calm, collective. He would reach, yudriku is to reach. A lot does he reach, al-mut'anni, the one who's calm, ba'adha hajati, some of his needs. وَقَدْ يَكُونُ مَعَ الْمُسْتَعْجِلُ الزَّلَلُ, and a lot is with the hasty one, mistakes. Mistakes that occur from him. We took that now. Now we're going to move on to the alamat, which are mukhtassa, specific to the fi'l mudari'. وَأَمَّا السِّينُ وَالسَّوْفَ فَيَدْخُلَانِ عَلَى الْفِعْلِ الْمُضَارِعِ وَحْدَهُ. These are mukhtassa. The seen and the sofa, they both enter what? They both enter the fi'l mudari', and they're specific to it. وَهُمَا يَدُلَّانِ عَلَى التَّنْفِيسِ, and both of them show the future. وَمَعْنَاهُ الْإِسْتِقْبَالِ, تَنْفِيس, it means istiqbal, it's the same meaning. إِلَّا أَنَّ السِّينَ أَقَلَّ إِسْتِقْبَالًا مِنْ سَوْفَ. The only difference between seen and sofa is that seen, it shows less of a future than what sofa shows. فَأَمَّا السِّينُ فَنَحْوَ قَوْلِهِ تَعَالَى. The example for seen is like the statement of Allah, سَيَقُولُ السُّفَهَاءُ مِنَ النَّاسِ, the dim-witted ones will be saying from the people. And the statement of Allah, سَيَقُولُ لَكَ الْمُخَلَّفُونَ, the ones who have stayed away from the battle and they stayed back, they will say to you, Muhammad. وَأَمَّا سَوْفَ, as for sofa, فَنَحْوُ قَوْلِهِ تَعَالَى, it's like the statement of Allah, وَلَسَوْفَ يُعْطِيكَ, your Lord will give you, فَتَرْضَى, and you're going to be pleased with it. وَلَسَوْفَ يُعْطِيكَ رَبُّكَ فَتَرْضَى, and also سَوْفَ نُصْلِيهِمْ نَارًا, Allah is saying sofa, we will destroy them and punish them in the hellfire. And also the statement of Allah, سَوْفَ يُؤْتِيهِمْ, Allah will bring to them أُجُورَهُمْ, their righteous deeds and their reward. وَأَمَّا تَاءُ التَّأْنِيثِ السَّاكِنَةِ, we're now going to move on to the فِعِلْ مَاضِي, the signs that are unique for it. The author here says, وَأَمَّا تَاءُ التَّأْنِيثِ السَّاكِنَةِ, which is here, this one, فَتَدْخُلُ عَلَى الْفِعِلِ الْمَاضِي, it enters into the فِعِلُ الْمَاضِي, دُونَ غَيْرِهِ, other than it. وَالْغَرَضُ مِنْهَا, and the intent behind it is, الدَّلَالَةُ عَلَى أَنَّ الْإِسْمَ الَّذِي أُسْنِدَ هَذَا الْفِعِلُ إِلَيْهِ مُؤَنَّثٌ. The ta'u ta'nith is sakina, the purpose behind it is just to show you that the person who did this action is a female. Okay? The one who came with this action, who this action has been attributed to, هذا الفعل إليه مؤنث is a female. سواء أكان فاعلا. Whether that is a فاعل, okay, that person in which it's been attributed to can either be a فاعل, such as قالت عائشة أم المؤمنين, عائشة said, the mother of the believers, this is عائشة is a فاعل. أم نائب فاعل, or it can be a نائب فاعل. نائب فاعل here is what? المفعول الذي لم يسمى فاعله. When the person who did the action is not known. فُرِشَتْ دَارُنَا بِالْبُسُطِ. The word فُرِشَتْ here is مَبْنِيُّ لِلْمَجْهُول. It's مَبْنِيُّ لِلْمَجْهُول. We don't know the person who did this action. Are you with me? So this is also نائب فاعل. But دَارُنَا بِالْبُسُطِ. So we know فُرِشَتْ, that the فعل here, what is being attributed to is a female, regardless of whether it is مبني للمعلوم or is مبني للمجهول. It doesn't matter. والمراد أنها ساكنة في أصل وضعها. But when we say that the word قالت, okay, فرشت, it's only ساكنة in its original construction. فلا يضر تحريكها لعارض. So don't feel that the ruling has changed if a haraka is put on it because of external reason. Okay? Such as من التقاء الساكنين, two sukuns are about to meet. في نحو قوله تعالى, like the statement of Allah, وقالت اخرج عليهن. Okay? Also وقالت امرأة العزيز. Or قالتا أتينا طائعين. Okay? These are all تاء التأنيث الساكنة, even though they have a حركة on it. The قالت is meant to be قالت. The reason why it has a كسرة here is what? I mentioned it before on the board. التقاء الساكنين, the meeting of two sukuns. وقالت امرأة العزيز. Also here is what? تاء التأنيث الساكنة. Don't let it confuse you that there's a كسرة on the تاء because it's التقاء الساكنين. قالتا أتينا طائعين. Again, the ta' here is ta' ta'nit al-sakina. Don't let it confuse you that there's a fatha on it. Again, it's what? Iltiqa al-sakinaini. وَمِمَّا تَقَدَّمَ. Based on what has gone, what we have previously mentioned, يَتَبَيَّنُ لَكَ, what it becomes clear for you is أن علامات الفعل التي ذكرها المؤلف على ثلاثة أقسام. That the types of signs that the author mentioned for the verbs are three. قِسْمٌ يَخْتَصُ بِالدُّخُولِ عَلَى الْمَاضِي وَهُوَ ta' ta'nit al-sakina. وقسم يختص بالدخول على المضارع وهو السين وسوف وقسم يشترك بينهما وهو قد. The author said it's three types. The first type is that which enters the ماضي and it's specific to it, which is the تاء التأنيث الساكنة. The second one is a type that enters the مضارع, which is unique to it. The third one is which is سين وسوف. The third one is shared between the two of them, which is قد. But the way we play put it out is better. Okay? وَقَدْ تَرَكَ عَلَامَةَ فِعْلِ الْأَمْرِ. The author said here that he left mentioning the sign of the فِعْلِ الْأَمْرِ. وَهِيَ دَلَالَتُهُ عَلَى الطَّلَبِ مَعَ قَبُولِهِ يَا الْمُخَاطَبَةِ. Okay? And that is, it accepts or it indicates a request. And it has to also accept the ya al-mukhataba. Now pay attention to this. The fi'l amar, the difference between it and the previous signs is that the previous signs, its sin is in there alone, it's sufficient for us to say this is a mudari'. If a sin is in a word, it's sufficient for us to say this is mudari', because sin by itself can indicate it. But the fi'l amar here, it's not enough for you to say dalalatu ala talab, that it shows a request. No. We say دلالته على الطلب مع قبول ياء المؤنثة المخاطبة. It also has to accept simultaneously the ياء المؤنثة المخاطبة. That whenever I wish I can add it into the word. Okay? But if a word shows a request, but it will not accept ياء المؤنثة المخاطبة, what does that say? It's not a فعل أمر. Okay? Like when somebody says to you, صح, be quiet. صح. It shows a request, but it doesn't accept ya al-mu'annathat al-mukhataba. So it's not fi'il amar. It's not a fi'il amar. Okay? The author here says it. أو نون التوكيدي. or it also accepts nunu tawkid. So ya al manat al mukhatabah or nunu tawkid, they're all the same. That accepts that. Okay? Nahu qawlik, like nahu qum, uq'ud, uqtub, unzur. He gave you four words. Qum, uq'ud, uqtub, unzur. All of those words are fi'l amr. Why? Because they what? Dalalatu ala talabi ma'a qabulihi ya al mu'annath al mukhataba. It shows a request and it will also accept ya al mu'annath al mukhataba if I wanted to add into it. Qum, qumi, uq'ud, uq'udi, uqtub, uqtubi. Last one is unzur, unzuri. Whatever I needed, I can add ya al mu'annath al mukhataba into it. فإن هذه الكلمات الأربعة دالة على طلب حصول القيام والقعود والكتابة والنظر مع قبولها يا المخاطبة في نحو قومي واقعدي مع قبولها نون التوكيد في اكتبنا انظر انظرن اكتبن إلى ما ينفعك. And I explained that to you. They all accept the يا المؤنث المخاطبة. And they also what? They also show a request. So the word qum, it shows you what? The request of standing up. Uq'ud, it shows you the request of qu'ud, sitting. Uqtub shows you the request of writing. Unzur, it shows you the request of looking at something. And they each accept the ya al-mu'annath al-mukhataba. And inshaAllah ta'ala, we're going to conclude there bi-idhnillahi al-kareem. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and Shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.